Welcome back to Breslov Campus. Beautiful insight in the Megillah coming up for Purim, which we're very excited and anticipating with longing and yearning to receive this light and miracle of Purim Bezrat Hashem. An insight based on Rabbi Nachman's teachings, Likutei Moran Lesson 44. Rabbi Nachman teaches that when a person has all types of distracting thoughts in his prayer, all types of confusions and bilbulim, all types of confusions and distractions and everything, the rectification for them is the Holy Land, is connecting to and activating the holiness of Eretz Yisrael, the land of Israel, in a person's existence. He gives several advices how to do so, Rabbi Nachman. And by being connected to the Holy Land, this can banish the distracting foreign thoughts. Now, in the context of the Megillah, Haman signifies these confusions and doubts and all types of bothering thoughts to prevent a person from davening. Because the idea of prayer is faith. Prayer represents faith. Because you only daven to Hashem if you believe that He's listening to you. And as we're taught in the Megillah, that Haman made himself like an idol. He put an idol on his garment, and everyone had to bow down and prostrate to him. So in that way, they were bowing and prostrating to idolatry, which is the opposite of faith, the opposite of davening. And also that Haman's tactic was to get the Jews detached from the Holy Land, and thus having no power to being able to pray properly. So that was Haman's essence. It was the antithesis of davening. Now, he eventually was hung on a pole, which was 50 cubits high. The Midrash says that where did Haman get this 50 cubit tall, high pole? His son, Parshandata, had pieces of wood left from the Ark of Noah. And the wood used for the Ark of Noah had to be very, very long pieces of wood, right? Because that was the Ark. So he said he had this 50 cubit long piece of wood from the Ark of Noah, and Parshandata suggested to Haman, use this to hang Haman, to hang Mordechai. And in the end, Haman himself was hung on this tree, this wooden pole. This wooden pole being part of the Ark of Noah, and the Ark of Noah is the exact opposite of the flood. Rabbi Nachman teaches that the flood waters, the Mabul, correspond to also, like Haman, the confusing and distracting thoughts during davening. That's the idea of a Mabul. And the Ark, which protected from the Mabul, signifies purity of thought. The word for Ark in Hebrew is Teva. Rabbi Nachman teaches Teva also means words of prayers. So the Ark is the words of prayers, which are protected from the storm waters of the flood. In other words, holy, pure prayer. So in the end, it worked out that Haman, the antithesis of prayer, the one who is distracting and confusing and messing up a person's davening, that's the idea of Haman, he was hung on a pole taken from the Ark of Noah, and the Ark of Noah signifies concentration in prayer. So it was exactly worked out, Midah Keneged Midah. He deserved exactly what he got. He was hung by a pole from a wooden part of the Ark, which corresponds to pure, sincere words, Teva, of prayer.